Hello everyone, it's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with this week's edition of Protect Your Portfolio. In this weekly presentation, we take a longer-term look at the North American markets using weekly charts. We use weekly charts to help filter out all of that market noise from Monday to Friday, so we're left with just one decision point, and that is the closing price from 4 p.m. Friday afternoon. Now, I don't have a lot new to report this weekend. If you were with us at this time last week, we were bullish on the market long-term. And that would have changed if the VIX had have closed above $21.06 on Friday. That did not happen. In fact, over the past five trading days, the VIX continued to move lower, down nearly 20% on the week, and it made a new low for this move. And so this coming Friday, we're going to remain bullish on the market as long as the VIX does not close above $19.65. Let's expand the charts out a bit, and we'll look at some daily and weekly charts. Again, it's 1965. That's what we're looking for. A close above that on Friday would turn us bearish. If you're trading during the week, then right now on the daily charts, the upper channel line is up at $15.48. And of course, that upper channel line is going to continue to drop daily. Moving from the VIX to the major market ETFs, starting with the Dow Diamonds, up 1.64% on the week. Looking at a daily chart of the Dow Diamonds, you see that we only came back on a buy signal on Friday, and the Dow had a rough week because of weakness in one stock, and that, of course, was Boeing. Looking at the spider for the S&P 500, you can see we're up nearly 3% on the week, and we had a couple of days we're on a buy signal there, and you can see that we've taken out the previous high. And then looking at the NASDAQ 100, looking at the Qs, we were up over 4%. So obviously technology stocks leading the market higher. And there's a daily chart of the Qs. Again, we've taken out the previous high and we're on to bigger and better things. Looking north of the border, the TSX was up just over 1% on the week and still on a daily buy signal. We had some weakness last week, traded through the lower channel line, but did not close below it. So, you know, even though we spent all day below the lower channel line, at the end of the day, they came back and bought it back up into the channel. So no sell signal there. Let's slip in a couple of quick tutorials. The first one is the Dow. The Dow is the most referenced, the most talked about index in the world, but it is the least traded, the least followed by professional traders. And I'll show you that in a second, but you know, the Dow's been around the longest. If you turn on the news, if you're in the car and you happen to turn the news on, and that particular newscast wants to tell you what happened to the stock market today, they'll probably quote the Dow. But once you get inside the marketplace and you become a professional trader or, you know, a full-time investor or whatever, you're not going to focus on the Dow at all. And I'll just show you how that works in real life. If we look at the volumes from the major ETFs from Friday's trading action, the Dow Diamonds only had 4 million shares trade. Now, that could be a lot. So when I say only 4 million shares, for a particular stock, that could be an enormous amount. But when you look at it compared to its peers, there's the Spider ETF for the S&P 500 at 81 million shares. There's the NASDAQ 100 at 38 million shares. And even if you look at the Russell 2000, the iShares for the Russell 2000, we're looking at 22 million shares on Friday. So really, you know, when it comes to, you know, people putting their money down and trading something, it isn't the Dow, it isn't the Dow Diamonds, it's the S&P 500, the Qs, and the iShares. So just remember that if you're trying to track the market, if you're trying to play the market, if you're trying to follow the market, don't use the Dow. Now, the second tutorial, we'll take a quick look at Boeing, and Boeing gapped lower, ending the week down 10%. If you had have bought Boeing on the weekly charts, you would have bought it back here in early January at just over $340. And of course, at that time, you would have looked up, you would have put a sell order in at 375. And when that got filled, you would have put in a sell order in at 347.50. And when that got filled, you would have put an order in up at 500. Unfortunately, we never got to break away from the 437.50 level, and we came back down to the 375 level. Now, we're holding 375 so far. If we take out last week's low, and then you need to look down. We're so far, we're clustering around the 375 level. There was an open gap that was filled that's acting as support. And with this daily chart, we need to close above $409 to give us a buy signal on Monday. Unfortunately, to get there, you're going to have to break through the top of or the bottom of an open gap. And so that could be a problem and would stop us from generating a daily buy signal. Now, if we take out last week's low, then you have to start looking lower. And on the weekly charts, that's down at 312.50. Of course, as you're coming down to 312.50, you're getting close to that big round number at 300. And so our target to the downside is, yes, mathematically it is 312.50, but you always want to round up and round down to the big round numbers because psychologically that's what the public uses as their targets. And so we'd be looking at buyers coming in at that level to because they think they're getting a great deal, and that could be enough to find a bottom for this stock. But to get down to the 300, 312.50 level, you got to take out last week's low, and we haven't done that yet. Next up, let's take a quick look at the marijuana cannabis market. And the Horizon Beta Pro ETF was up over 5% on the week, but had an inside week. So not everybody was moving higher. And most of the gains in this sector was from Aurora Cannabis, which was up nearly 24% on the week. And then we had Hexo, which was up just a little over 12% on the week, while Canopy Growth was basically unchanged, had an inside week there. So a couple stocks did really well, the rest of the market not so much for the week, but we're still looking for bigger and better things in that sector. Finishing off, looking at commodities and starting with crude oil. Crude oil was up on the week, a little over 4%. Pros certainly in control, starting to break away from 56.25, heading towards 62.50. Unfortunately, we're stuck at the cluster of moving averages, the 50, the 100, the 200-day moving average, and we're in the flypaper. So that's going to take a little bit of work to get there. Looking at natural gas, we are down on the week, still trading and closing below the lower channel line, so not there's no level of excitement for natural gas. Copper, you can see we're projecting up towards the 320 level, and mathematically our next target is 313, but we're still closing below the 293, and especially closing below the $3 level. The high of the week was 295, so obviously there are some sellers in there along the $3 level, and so we're looking to see if we can take that out. If we can do that, then 313 comes into focus. And of course you can see that we had a bearish reversal week a couple of weeks ago. We still haven't taken out that high, so that is holding us in check. Looking down, of course, we need to close this coming Friday below 277, not expecting that to happen. Then looking at gold, top of the range, 1343.75, bottom of the range, 1281.25, still holding above that. Pros are still in control. That would be the blue line here. And then, of course, we're looking at our channel lines, and we've been playing with the lower channel line for the past couple of weeks but have not closed below it. In fact, we close higher on the week, just above $1,300. This coming Friday, we would sell gold if we close below 1286.26. Okay, folks, that is all for today's presentation. Have a great day. Have a great weekend. And the next time you'll hear my voice is on Tuesday morning. And at that time, we'll take a closer look at the U.S. stock market.